Chalmers, I'm Megan Kostrowski.
And I'm Siri Thompson, and this is Atomic TV.
There's one remaining open house opportunity for prospective Washington Youth Academy students and families. It'll be Saturday, June the 2nd at 10 o'clock. Please see Mrs. Markell with questions.
Now let's head over to a message from Mrs. Dartnell.
There's nothing there in the book drop tonight, not a book or magazine. A kingdom of circulation, and it looks like I'm the queen. Fill up the book drop, oh, that's where my heart still yearns. Gotta bring them back, gotta please return. Don't keep them out, they're overdue. To clear them all, here's what you have to do. No one more day, no wait and see. Just pay a fee. Bring them back, bring them back. You can't check them out anymore. Bring them back, bring them back. You can visit the
Seniors, bring your books back. It's time.
Now back to the studio.
Hello, everyone. I am so excited to congratulate you all and thank you for celebrating College Signing Day. This is a big deal, and you did it. You were accepted to college, and now you're letting the world know where you're going to go this fall. And I'm so proud of all of you guys. But remember, your journey is just beginning, and I don't want you to stop until you get that college degree. So enjoy today and tell us where you're going next by posting a selfie in your college gear with the hashtag #ReachHigher. And then finish out this year strong and show everyone what you've got next fall at college. Congratulations and good luck.
Who helped you navigate college?
I was lucky enough to go to college after my older sister had been in college already, and so she answered a lot of my questions about how to apply for college, how to apply for scholarships, how to, and you know, once you're enrolled, what do you do? How do you check into your dorm? All of those kinds of things. So ask lots of questions of anybody you know who's already been in college.
Any advice for graduating seniors?
I would say just appreciate life. It's so easy to get caught up with school and with work, but I would say life is about experiences too. So just don't be afraid of trying new things and doing something different. And remember that, you know, it's balance between school and life, and you have to live life too and just enjoy it and go try new things.
What are things that you wish you would have known?
Things I wish I would have known is, number one, how difficult it is to get a job when you have zero job experience. Make sure you don't get discouraged, always be positive, and as long as you have a good attitude about things, you'll find a job. Other things I wish I would have known, to make sure that if you're gonna pull an all-nighter, you have caffeine. It's really hard in college when you're studying for finals and you need to have your caffeine, so make sure you have caffeine. And I think that's it.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Markson, and I went to Eastern Washington University in Cheney for my undergrad, and I loved Eastern. I chose to go to Eastern because a lot of my friends went to WSU, and I wanted to go somewhere where I didn't know as many people and I had a new experience. I also chose Eastern because a lot of teachers go to Eastern because it's a teaching college, and I loved it. Go Eagles.
How do you stay motivated in college?
So I think in order to stay motivated, you gotta mix the hard work with some fun, for sure. So there's so many things at college that you can do. I remember in my college days, lots of intramural sports. You gotta relive the glory days in all kinds of different sports. We played volleyball, football, basketball, even like ping pong and all these weird things we'd never really played, but did a lot of that stuff, especially all the math parties on the weekends too. Those are definitely a lot of fun to go to.
So how would you say you'd stay motivated in college?
A couple of ways. One, I think who you surround yourself is really important. On college campuses, you know, if you're around people that are motivated, that's going to wear off on you. Also, having a plan. If you've got an end goal, I think that always is helpful because you sort of have a finish line that you're looking towards.
And is there any advice for graduating seniors?
Yeah, if you're going to do student loans, research them. Research the payment plans, research the interest rates. If your parents gonna have to take loans out, I mean, like, talk to a financial advisor. It sometimes what they sell you on is not exactly the reality, so really be careful with loans. And then again, just have a plan with that sort of stuff so that once you do graduate, you aren't crippled with debt and an indentured servant to the government.
Who helped you navigate through college?
To navigate through college, I honestly just motivated myself. I mean, I did have friends and family members who helped me along the way, but the majority of my efforts in college were due to me and wanting to do better in my own future.
The first annual college signing celebration is on Friday, June 1st, as a part of Washington's College Access Initiative. Richland High School will be recognizing seniors at 11:15 during lunch for their accomplishment of making post-secondary plans. The goal of this program is to highlight all seniors who commit to making plans after high school. During this event, seniors who will be recognized for choosing to enroll in community colleges, technical programs, private colleges, public universities, and enlisting in the military. Hundreds of seniors are expected to participate. You do not want to miss this event.
Over this Memorial Day weekend, a student from Hanford, Dimitri Woody, lost his life. Our hearts go out to the Hanford students and his friends and family at this time. We are keeping all of you in our thoughts and prayers.
Now please stand for the pledge.